The SpaceX Navy has grown by one. We're talking about that coming up. Hey guys, Tori here from Overlook Horizon. If you're new to the channel, we fly high altitude weather balloon flights to the edge of space and back. And along the way, we talk about space, science, and technology. So if that's something you're interested in, please consider subscribing. Today, we're talking about SpaceX's newest addition to their naval fleet, which is Go Mischief. Now you might be thinking, wait a minute, what does SpaceX need a naval fleet for? Well, SpaceX utilizes a number of different ships and vessels for their recovery efforts during their Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy launches. Probably the most well-known of those is their autonomous spaceport drone ships, Of Course I Still Love You, and Just Read the Instructions. Those are the drone ships that float out in the middle of the ocean that actually catch the Falcon 9 first stage booster when it returns back and does an ocean landing. In addition to those ships though, they also have some support ships like Go Searcher, Go Navigator, Go Pursuit. They perform things like crew support operations as well as payload fairing recovery for when they soft land the payload fairings in the ocean. Now, speaking of payload fairings, they don't always soft land them in the water. They also have this gigantic boat, formerly known as Mr. Steven and now known as Go Miss Tree. The idea of reusing some of these payload fairings has been around since about 2017 for SpaceX, but they started doing their first catch attempts in 2018. They tried a number of times unsuccessfully. They also upgraded and increased the size of the net on Mr. Steven, but still couldn't get a successful catch. Just earlier this year in 2019, Mr. Steven actually suffered some damage while at sea going out to do a payload fairing recovery, but before it could do the recovery attempt, it suffered some damage to its arms, had to return back to Port Canaveral, and seemingly needed to be repaired. But Mr. Steven actually spent months in Port Canaveral with no movement and no signs of repair. In fact, when I was down there for CRS-17 back in April, it was still in port, unrepaired, and it had been that way since February. So a lot of people, including myself, thought that maybe SpaceX was giving up on this payload fairing recovery idea, at least as far as the net catch is concerned. It seemed like they might be able to get it to work, but after those arms were damaged, it seemed like maybe they had given up. In fact, on the second Falcon Heavy flight, which was for Arabsat 6A, they soft landed both halves of the payload fairing in the water and then did a water recovery from them with Go Searcher and Go Navigator. SpaceX also announced after that recovery that they were going to reuse those payload fairing halves for a future Starlink mission. So again, thought maybe they were done with this. But despite my thoughts and the thoughts of many others, it was repaired and they brought Mr. Steven back out with a name change, Go Mischief. Now, Go Mischief is not actually owned by SpaceX. It was formerly owned by a company named Seatran Marine. They ran into a bit of financial trouble and had to sell it off to Geiss Offshore. I think that's how you say it. Geiss? I don't know. I'm gonna go with Geiss. Now, the previous name of that ship, Mr. Steven, was after the CEO's father for the former company. So it only made sense to kind of rename the boat, and that's where Mischief came in. All of the Geiss Offshore boats start with the acronym GO, G-O, for the company name. With a new name and those arms repaired, Mischief headed out to sea for the third Falcon Heavy flight and performed a successful payload fairing half recovery, where it actually landed and parachuted into the net on the back of that ship. This was pretty incredible. It finally proved their concept that they could do it. But now the question was consistency. Could they do it again? And they did prove on AMOS 17 that they could do it again, because they had another amazing catch of a payload fairing half in the back of the Mischief boat. So with SpaceX getting some consistency behind these payload fairing catches, they're now going to utilize a second ship to catch the other half of the payload fairing. And that is where our new ship, Go Mischief, comes in. Go Mischief was also previously owned by that other company, Seatran Marine. They sold it off to Geiss Offshore. It was previously named Captain Elliot, and it's now renamed to Go Mischief. Now, it's estimated that it cost SpaceX about $3 million to operate each one of those boats, so operating two of them is gonna be about $6 million per year. Incidentally, those payload fairings actually cost about $6 million, so just a single catch will break even for the entire year. They can catch more than that, gravy. Now, it's going to be a little while before we see Mischief in service. Mischief is a nearly identical boat, but it doesn't have the arms and the net yet. So, question of the day, how long do you think it's going to be until we see Mischief in service? When will we see a catch? Are we talking weeks, months, a year? Let me know what you guys think in the comments section down below. As always, thanks to our Patreon supporters for making videos like this possible. If you like this kind of stuff, please like the video and consider subscribing and connecting with our community. All right, thanks everybody for watching. We'll see you in the next video.